grateful that the magistrates are sent through this Shamoga tribe and vacated all orders that were issued, which those orders in the first place were an oxymoron, as my lawyer described them at that time, because she dismissed the application and then went on to issue a cash bail. He told me to report for 10 days to the police for 10 days, which was basically jailing me outside the prison. And that means, on top of not having my equipment for the last, since I was arrested on 6 of April, my phones and my laptop finished, which means I can't work. I've also had to report to the police every day since I was. Since that day, which is basically means my whole life has been around this case. So that is punishment, that is unconstitutional, and we will consult with my legal team in terms of what compensation the state needs to do for that harassment. Because basically what I'm being done is being harassed for speaking out and trying to hold my leadership, the president and others, to account.
The Inspector General of Police and the DCI needs to be better advised to stop using legal power in a manner that is oppressive. Because can you imagine if the court had admitted Mr. Kiama, if the court had accepted the application last time to detain him for 14 days to investigate something they don't have? Can you imagine detaining a person's liberty even for 1 second is very, very critical. The detention of his equipment so far means that he has been disabled from earning a living, that he can no longer work, even when we are being told to work from home because of the COVID-19, and working from home, the office becomes your telephone and your computer, and now Mr. Kiama here is unable to work and therefore earn a living.